वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, क्लास 9 साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी 1, चैप्टर 2 वर्क एंड एनर्जी, पार्ट 1 वर्क। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट वर्क। सो लेट अस बिगिन टुडेज डिस्कशन विद दिस पिक्चर। Observe these pictures. Can you tell about this? In the first picture, a girl is sitting on her place and reading. In the second picture, a boy is playing with a ball. In the third picture, a girl is watching television. And in the fourth picture, a man is carrying loads and walking on his way. Can you tell in which of these pictures work has been done? You're right. In all these 4 pictures, we say work has been done. Second thing, from the scientific point of view, when do we say work is not done? When the displacement of body is 0. Or the displacement is taking perpendicular to the applied force, or when there is no net force acting on any object, then in all these cases we say work is not done. Dear students, from the previous discussion we can say that generally any mental or physical activity is referred as work is done. When we walk or we run or we are using energy in our body, we say normally work is done. In the previous discussion, the girl who is writing or watching TV is also doing work. That is a mental work. In physics, we deal with physical work. We can define work as when a force is applied on an object and it causes the displacement of object, then we say work is done. From this, we can write the formula for work as work is equal to force into displacement. So, dear students, from this discussion, we can conclude that when force is applied on an object and object is making displacement, then we say that work is done. Formula of work can be written as work is equal to force into displacement. That is, W is equal to F into S. Can you recall what are the different types of forces with their examples? Let us observe about the forces and their examples. There are different types of forces: contact forces, non-contact forces. Balance force: forces acting on an object if are equal called balance forces. Forces when are unequal acting on an object then called as unequal or unbalanced forces. In this case, object moves in the direction of more force. Next is contact forces. When object are is in contact with each other, their force act between is contact force. Muscular force: the forces resulting in muscular activity. Dear students, friction is the force that opposes the motion between the surface and the object in contact. The next is magnetic force. When a magnet is kept near to the magnetic substances, they get attracted toward the magnet due to the magnetic force. The next is gravitational force. Because of the Earth's force exerted on an object, the object gets attracted toward Earth. Here, this is the electrostatic force.
When an object is getting rubbed with the other object, the force of attraction developed between them is nothing but the electrostatic force. Force exerted by a charged body on the another charged or uncharged body is the electrostatic force.
Suppose Meenakshi displaces a wooden block from point A to point B along the surface of the table. As force is applied on the block, energy is spent in order to move the box from one position to another position. So the question is whether all the energy is used to accelerate the object, which forces have been overcoming using this energy. Let's discuss and observe.
Dear students, when the block of wood is displaced from point A to point B along the surface of table on applying the force F, then we have to find whether all the energy spent has been used to produce the acceleration in the block or not. So we can say here, when force is applied on an body, then the whole energy spent by it is used to produce acceleration in the block. And secondly, which forces has been overcome using that energy? So here we say gravitational force and frictional force have been overcome using the whole energy.
Now we will go to the second example. Observe these two pictures. A girl is pulling a cart with the help of string and a cart is moving. Here we say that a force is applied along the direction of the string and a car is moving to the horizontal plane in the direction of a component of the direction of the displacement. Then we can derive the equation for work done as, if F is the force applied, S is the displacement of object and theta is the angle between the factor of displacement and force applied, then we say work done is equal to component of the force multiplied by displacement. The component of the force we can calculate by using the trigonometric ratio, cosine. Since we know this is the angle formed between force and component of force in the direction of the displacement, if you will draw the perpendicular, then a right angle triangle is formed, and this angle theta is nothing but the cosine angle. Cos theta is equal to base upon hypotenuse. Thus we say W is equal to F into cos theta into S. Let us study the different cases related to this.
Dear students, as we know, work done by the force F1 is equal to force into cos theta into displacement. Dear students, on putting the different values of theta, we get the different conclusions related to work. When theta is 0, cos theta is equal to 1 and work is equal to force into displacement. The work done by the force is positive and maximum because of the force and displacement have the same direction. When theta is 90 degree, the cos theta is equal to 0 and work is also 0. The work done is 0 because of displacement is perpendicular to the force. When value of theta is equal to 180 degree, cos theta is equal to negative 1 and work is equal to negative force into displacement. The work done is negative and minimum as the displacement is in the direction opposite to the force applied.
Dear students, here we go to discuss about unit of work and the different kinds of work done, that is positive work, negative work and zero work, with the reference of the angle formed and the displacement of.
Now students, we will discuss unit of work. Work is equal to force into displacement. In SI system, the unit of force is Newton and that of displacement is meters. Therefore, unit of work is equal to Newton into meter. This is called as joule. 1 joule is equal to the force applied of 1 Newton displaces an object through the 1 meter distance. In the direction of the force, the amount of work done is called as 1 joule. Therefore, 1 joule is equal to 1 Newton into 1 meter. 1 joule is equal to 1 Newton into 1 meter. In CGS system, the unit of force is dyne and the displacement is centimeter. Therefore, in CGS system, unit of work is equal to 1 erg. If a force of 1 dyne displaces an object through 1 centimeter in the direction of the force, the amount of work done is 1 erg. 1 erg is equal to 1 dyne into 1 centimeter. Now we will explain the relationship between joule and erg as 1 Newton is equal to 10 to the power 5 dyne and 1 meter is equal to 10 to the power 2 centimeter. Therefore, work is equal to force into displacement. 1 joule is equal to 1 Newton into 1 meter, which is equal to 10 to the power 5 dyne into 10 to the power 2 centimeter. At last, we say that 1 joule work is equal to 10 to the power 7 dyne into centimeter. That is, 1 joule is equal to 10 to the power 7 erg.
Hope the concept of work you have understood. Revise the topic. We will meet with the new topic in the next period. Thank you.